They wanted enlightenment. To get it, they would spend 3 years, 3 months, and 3 days meditating in the Arizona desert. This from their retreat video.
We're going to be in there for 3 years, working very, very hard to change the world. And we need a lot of love and support.
Christy McNally was the co-founder of the so-called Diamond Mountain University in the southern Arizona desert, where nearly 40 committed Buddhists paid thousands of dollars to build their own accommodations.
We also need a little bit of financial support, to tell you the truth.
Support that would allow those in the retreat to, as they call it, explore the inner space of the mind without worries about food, water, or other necessities. With McNally, her husband and yoga partner, Ian Thorson. They co-authored a book together on yoga.
Once we do this kind of yoga together, then the next day when we try to do like a series alone, it's really, really lonely, actually.
It's lonely.
Yeah.
The bliss was not to last. A year and a half into the retreat, both McNally and Thorson would be expelled. Then they seemingly disappeared. 3 months later, 38-year-old Thorson would be dead, Christy McNally at his side.
She was completely hysterical. According to her, she needed to stay with him for a three-day period to help his spirit to heaven.
Thorson died just a few miles from the retreat. He and McNally had made the fatal decision to continue it on their own, roughing it in the Arizona desert in the middle of winter on a nearby mountainside.
I wouldn't call it a cave. It was big boulders were, stacked.
But the pair had help. Someone was bringing them food and water from the base of the mountain. They had to come down and come back up in order to get it. At some point, they became too weak and too sick to actually do that. The coroner's report says that Thorson died of dehydration and starvation.
Despite their bad decision to rough it, Thorson's mother doesn't blame either her son or his wife. She puts the blame squarely on this man, Michael Roach, seen here in the retreat video.
What you're seeing here is the final party to celebrate the three-year retreat.
Co-founder of Diamond Mountain with McNally. He goes by Geshe Michael, the honorific title of a Tibetan Buddhist monk. Thorson's mother accuses Roach of running a cult and says the three-year retreat was just another step in establishing control over her son, Ian.
He changed radically, over a period of time. It doesn't happen overnight.
But there is more to the story. Before it was Christy and Ian, it was Christy and Michael. That's right. Michael Roach and McNally had done a three-year retreat starting in 1999, living in a yurt in the same Arizona desert, never more than 15 feet apart. Their relationship was frowned upon by Tibetan Buddhists, including the Dalai Lama, who disapproved of Roach wearing monastic robes, indicating celibacy, while apparently in a sexual relationship. They even made a series of videos about their spiritual partnership.
We're into how you look at things, how you view things.
The problem began in February, a little more than a year into the retreat. McNally gave a lecture indicating Ian had been violent toward her and she had accidentally stabbed him while practicing martial arts. Reason enough, Ian's mother contends, for Roach to expel Christy and her son. Days later, McNally received a letter from Michael Roach and the retreat's board of directors demanding to know details. She refused. In a rambling 31-page letter titled A Shift in the Matrix, she says she was treated with disrespect, calling the board's letter disturbing and a gross breach of the retreat. The dispute appears to have led to the couple's expulsion from the retreat. In his own open letter, Michael Roach said Ian had been cut three times, one which was deep enough to threaten vital organs. But the coroner's report only mentions a scar across Thorson's right shoulder.
He expelled the couple for whatever reasons. I don't think it's possible to justify something like that.
Expelled them and never informed the family, she says. Both Ian and Christy emerging from more than a year in the solitude of the retreat would have been in a delicate frame of mind. No charges were ever filed, and Arizona authorities consider the case closed. Michael Roach continues to run Diamond Mountain, traveling and spreading the gospel of Buddhism and business. He refused our every attempt to talk to him on camera. Last April, Ian Thorson was cremated in Arizona. What started as a journey toward enlightenment ended with his death and many unanswered questions.
It's such a bizarre tale. Miguel, I mean, if Ian Thorson's family is convinced it was a cult, did they try to do anything to get him out of it?
They did indeed. In the late 90s and early 2000s, they actually brought in experts. They brought him out to Long Island near where they live. They tried to basically mount an intervention to get him out of it. There was one scene where he became so upset and agitated in a car, he jumped out of a moving car and went running away from the family while in flip-flops, essentially. They had to go chasing him down. They tried everything that they could, they said, to try to get him away from Michael Roach, away from what they considered a cult, and never could. Mm.